My role here in EDPR, I'm the country manager for the US offshore wind business. And I've been here 3 years living in the US. I enjoyed my time in EDPR very much. And offshore wind is very exciting because there is so much going on, and the complexity of the marine environment I think makes it more challenging, and I like it. EDPR, as we all know, is a major player in the onshore wind business. However, offshore wind is more new. Just for comparison, there are, I think, around 500 gigawatts of onshore wind worldwide and 20 gigawatts of offshore wind. So offshore wind is basically harnessing the wind power located in offshore with wind turbines. And I would say the key difference is not only the marine environment, but also the consequences that it has. So the supply chain is different. The complexity of the installation and logistics is different. So offshore wind has other challenges, and lately has been successful by making larger projects and trying to tailor the components and the activities and the resources to the offshore marine environment. The US is the second largest market worldwide for renewables, I think after China. And for EDPR, it represents a major market. EDPR has been present in the US since 2007. And ever since, EDPR has been invested here doing onshore wind, solar, and more recently storage. So the US is a very key market for us. For offshore in particular, is new. The offshore market in the US is new. There is only 30 megawatts compared to 100 gigawatts onshore. The projects that we're working on, the number one is the joint venture with Shell. It's Mayflower Wind. This joint venture is a 50-50 joint venture. It successfully acquired a lease area, and we are now very pleased to hold that lease. That's our key asset.
Enrique and I met in late 2017 and began discussions about the opportunity. Shell has a very long history in the offshore energy space in the United States. So we felt combining our offshore expertise, both in the technical side, project delivery side, environmental, regulatory side, along with our very strong presence in the United States in the wholesale power markets. Those are the assets or the resources that we brought to the table. EDPR in the US with very, very strong onshore renewable development and delivery capabilities. The complementary skill sets that we bring together in the US create a pretty formidable team to be successful.
Our team in Boston is still fairly small, between less than 10 people, but yet we cooperate with dozens of people located in different geographies. I think EDP's model in offshore wind has been around partnerships, so our organization is tailored for these partnerships. In particular, the company Shell, the major oil group, who are our key partners in the project we're pursuing in Massachusetts.
Massachusetts was really the first state in the U.S. to push forward with a 1,600 megawatt initial target for offshore wind. The federal government was very aggressive in leasing offshore acreage, so we had, you know, kind of the state creating the demand side, the federal government with their leases creating the opportunity for the supply side, and you know, so that was really kind of what drove Massachusetts as the hub for offshore wind industry in the U.S.
In offshore wind in particular, the technology has evolved to such an extent that that's what has really made offshore wind successful. So, and then regarding the sun energy, there is PV, so photovoltaic, of course, is the mainstream, but there are many ways to harness that, and I mean, technology, it's coming out, and I'm sure there will be other technologies to harness these sources. I mean, solar energy seems to be the more plentiful, and I think society will be able to harness it better, and there are other renewable sources like geothermal, wave energy, currents, and I'm confident that EDP will be part of, you know, will be part of that story. Actually, we do work with EDP innovation team. and the floating technologies is probably one of the best examples. And you know, it's good to see that EDP is already thinking of that future, and we just hope that we can also, EDPR, be part of that.